Good evening, everybody. I would like to welcome everybody, all of the children, all of the families, and all of the staff to our carol service for 2021. Bells ring out. I'm especially delighted to welcome you all here today because, as you know, we weren't able to have a carol service last year. And it is by the grace of God that we are able to gather together this year, because there are many, many schools in the local area who have had to call off all of their Christmas events. So we are really, truly fortunate to be able to go ahead this year. That being said, I would like to just remind all of the adults, please, if you are able, make sure you're wearing a face covering over your mouth and nose. Another bit of housekeeping I need to make you aware of, if you haven't been told already on your way in, is that there is an ANPR system, camera system working in the car park. So if you have parked in the car park, please make sure you register your number plate as you exit the church. There are devices to put your number plate in as you leave so that you don't receive a fine. Now, the children, the staff, Mrs. Russell and Mrs. Wildman have worked exceptionally hard on their presentations this evening. I've caught glimmers of them throughout the weeks coming up to this evening, and they really are stunning. What I would like to remind everybody, though, that this is a service. I know you would be very, very tempted to fill the room with loud applause, but if you can resist, hopefully it won't interrupt the flow of the story, the most wonderful story that we are going to tell you this evening. Now, I'd like to hand over to Father Patrick, who is going to open our carol service with a prayer.
Thank you, Mr. Martin. May we please stand? In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Holy Father, we thank you for the gift of your Son to us, the Emmanuel, God with us. We thank you for keeping us alive, sustaining our faith to this day. We thank you most especially for our children, our schools, our teachers. We commend this Christmas service into your hands, O Lord. As we sing the carols, may they constantly remind us of the great mystery of your Son and draw us nearer to the one who came to die so that we may live. Take possession of this celebration, direct their face, sustain the children, and may we all seek to love you as we ought through this evening carol service. These and more we ask through Christ our Lord. Amen. May we please sit.
each Christmas, we celebrate God's precious gift to us, His only Son, Jesus, Lord Jesus Christ, child in a manger.
We gather together today to hear with joy the message brought by angels. We will journey in heart and mind to Bethlehem to reflect on the nativity of our Saviour and to bow in adoration and humility before Him.
We shall do this through song and through listening to the Holy Word of God, and as we lift up our hearts in praise. We shall also pray for peace on earth, for fellowship among those created in the image of God, for care of the poor and needy, for the unity of the church and for ourselves.
Once in royal David's city stood a lonely cattle shed where a mother laid her baby in a manger for his bed. Mary was that mother.
A reading from the book of Isaiah the prophet. A reading from the book of Isaiah the prophet. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. They lived in a land of shadows, but now the light is shining on them. A child is born to us, a son is given to us, and he will be our ruler. He will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Eternal Father, Prince of Peace. His royal power will continue to grow. His kingdom will always be at peace.
ring out. Let our voices lift in prayer as we remember how Isaiah foretold that a great king would come to free us from the things that bind and oppress us, how he would come to bring peace instead of violence, and to establish an everlasting and perfectly just kingdom. Whatever the challenges we are facing in our lives, whatever those around us are struggling with, Jesus came to bring this to bring light to this darkness.
Ring out the message of a new king. Good news, good news, good news for all the world.
One day, God sent his messenger to a town called Nazareth to a girl called Mary, who was engaged to a man called Joseph. The messenger said, "Rejoice, Mary, for the Lord has blessed you and he is with you now. Do not be afraid. God is very pleased with you. Listen, you are going to have a baby and you will call him Jesus." Then Mary said, "I am the servant of God. I am glad to do whatever he wants."
Ring out. Let our voices lift in prayer as we celebrate your birth, which turned the world upside down. We pray for those facing change and coming to terms with unexpected news. Bless us in the opportunities we are given and in the challenges we face.
Great joy, great joy.
reading from St. Luke's Gospel. Now at this time, the Roman Emperor, Caesar Augustus, ordered that a census should be taken of the entire Roman Empire. Everyone had to go to their hometown to register their name so that they could be counted. Mary and Joseph had to travel a great distance to their hometown of Bethlehem. It was not a good time for Mary to travel, for she was about to give birth. But they had to obey the emperor's order. When they arrived in Bethlehem, there was no room for them anywhere.
Ring out, let our voices lift in prayer, as we pray for those who cannot stop, whose journey of life is hard and long, and of heavy burdens to carry. Give strength for each next step, and light to show the way.
The world. Ring out, ring out.
Why they're in Bethlehem. A reading from St. Luke's Gospel. While they were in Bethlehem, the time came for Mary to have her child, a son, her firstborn. She wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger because there was no room for him at the inn.
Ring out, let our voices lift in prayer as we celebrate the birth of Jesus our Saviour. It shows us your great love. We thank you for the joy of human birth. Protect and strengthen all babies and those who care for them.
Ring out, ring out the message of a new king. Good news. Good news, good news for all the world. Ring out, ring out.
Reading from St. John's Gospel, the Word became flesh. He lived among us, and we saw his glory, the glory that he has from the Father as only Son of the Father, full of grace and truth.
Ring out, let our voices lift in prayer as we remember, Lord. You called us and brought light into our lives, and now you ask us to be your light in the continuing darkness. Help us always to let your light shine through us in your words and actions.
Ring out, our God has come among us.
On the hillside, far above Bethlehem, a group of shepherds were watching their sheep by moonlight. They were sleepy, hungry, and huddled up tight against the cold when suddenly God's angel appeared to them in a blaze of light.
Ring out. Let our voices lift in prayer as we remember when the angels filled the sky with praise because of you. May our lives be lit up with joy at the good news of the gift of Jesus, Christ to the entire world, today and always.
Ring out, our God has come among us. Great joy.
A reading from St. Luke's Gospel. The shepherds didn't waste a minute and hurried to Bethlehem. They quickly found the stable and found Mary and Joseph and the baby. They told them everything they had heard. Mary listened carefully to their story, and she kept all these things in her mind.
Ring out, let our voices lift in prayer as we remember when you came in silence of the night, an extraordinary gift to ordinary people. Help us to see the wonderful things you are doing in the ordinary experiences of our lives.
Ring out, ring out the message of the new king. Good news, good news, good news for the world. Ring out, our God has come among us. Great joy.
A reading from St. Matthew's Gospel. After Jesus had been born in Bethlehem, some wise men came from the east to King Herod in Jerusalem. They asked, "Where is the newborn king of the Jews? We have seen his star rising in the east, and we want to honor him."
Ring out, let our voices lift in prayer, as we remember the wise men who brought myrrh, frankincense, and gold to you. We remember, too, that we have nothing of our own to give to you, but we bring you what you have given us, our lives for your life.
Savior's birth foretold, generations waiting for a sign.
The sign and the king we have read.
Please could the children who are forming the tableau take their positions.
And so, at last tonight, we find the baby king, and overwhelmed with wondrous joy, our hearts begin to sing. This is truly God's own son, a gift from God above, surrounded by us all today, surrounded in the warmth of love.
Thank you. Okay, this isn't working. Let me see, tiny. No.
Full of fun. Christmas is happy, love to everyone. Christmas is joyful, love to the men and love people who are far, far. Christmas is happy, Christmas is full of fun. Christmas is happy, love to everyone. Love to the poor ones, love to the sick in bed, love to the poor. Christmas is happy, Christmas is full of fun. Christmas is happy, love to everyone.
I heard the bells on Christmas Day, the old familiar carols play, and wild and sweet the words repeat of peace on earth, goodwill to men.
When the song of the angels is stilled, when the star in the sky is gone, when the kings and princes are home, when the shepherds are back with their flocks, then the work of Christmas begins. To find the lost, to heal those broken in spirit, to feed the hungry, to release the oppressed, to rebuild the nations, to bring peace among all peoples, to make a little music with the heart, and to radiate the light of Christ every day, in every way, in all that we do and in all that we say. Then the work of Christmas begins.
We have shared in the wonderful story of Mary and Joseph, of angels and shepherds and wise men, and of Jesus himself, God with us. This Christmas, in the midst of our busy lives, we are invited to make room for the manger and gaze in wonder at the miracle of heaven touching earth. Rejoicing in the presence of God here among us, let us pray with confidence as Jesus himself taught us. May we please stand and say to our Father. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Amen. May we sit.
Good evening, Father Patrick. All the mums and dads, ladies and gentlemen, I can see grandmas and granddads and aunts and uncles, boys and girls. Can I say, I am so proud to be a member of St. Elphege's School. You have been absolutely wonderful. Your parents and everyone here should be so proud of what you have done this evening. You have brought us the story of Christmas in the most beautiful and wonderful way. It has been the most wonderful night. And I think because last year we couldn't do any of this, and as Mr. Jones said at the beginning, very few schools are able to do this. So I thank all the parents for being allowing your children to take part, to all of you here for joining us, because what we're doing is remembering what is important. And I know how much all the children love a present, don't you? You'd be telling me a lie if you said no. Of course you love presents, and we love all the excitement and everything that goes with Christmas, but there wouldn't be Christmas if we didn't remember that Jesus was born and came amongst us so that we can be with him. So thank you, children. It has been a wonderful evening. I am so impressed. And as I said, I am so proud to be a member of St. Elphege's School. I'd like to thank all the staff because it doesn't happen in the wink of an eye. And I must say, I think this might be one of the best years for a carol service I've ever attended. And I've been coming here, I'm not going to tell you how many years, but my son, my eldest son, is 42. So I've been around for a while, but it is absolutely beautiful. And I would like to say a really special thank you, beside the staff, to Mrs. Russell and Mrs. Wildman. Where are you, Mrs. Russell? Okay, children, enough's as good as a feast. No more clapping. Right. I think this is what we have a special. No, can I just finish what I'm saying? Mrs. Russell left us a few, well, I don't know when, because I've never seen, she's always there. But I know that the carol service and many other things would not happen without her hard work and her wonderful imagination and creativity, and that inspires us all. So I'd like to say thank you, Mrs. Russell, and thank you also to Mrs. Wildman, who actually is like the servant of Mrs. Russell at times. It's true. Mrs. Wildman is very good, and she does as she's told, unlike some people here. Right, so to all the parents, all the grandparents, the aunts, the uncles, the friends of our school, all the children, all the staff, I wish you the very happiest of Christmases. Stay safe, look after yourselves, look after your families, and enjoy what we can actually do together. And I'm not sure, are we having a collection? Where's Mrs. Haridas? We've got a, yes, it's a Catholic church. We are having a collection, and that will be for all our charities, our school in Ghana, a young man in Uganda, and for our own food bank and our families that really need our help. And I'd like to say, lastly, a really special thank you to Father Patrick and Father Gerard. Thank you, Father, for allowing us to be part of this evening and for sharing this with us, and thank you for being with us tonight. To all of you, have a wonderful Christmas, and I think the children are going to sing that to you as well. Thank you. And now you may clap.